Hello, welcome to Connie Martinson Talks Books. Well, I have a book for you that you're not going to put down because it's interesting, it is fun, and it's based on real people. My guest is Vicki Teal. The book is called It's All About the Dress, but forget that. It's all about the people in the book and her loves. And it's published by St. Martin's Press. Welcome, Vicki, and thank you for my hours of fun reading this book.
I'm really thrilled. God bless you. Makes me happy.
Well, it'll make a lot of, I mean, not that everything ran smoothly.
To me, it did.
After the fact.
No, I'm just someone who, when I have a difficult situation, I think about it for a few seconds, figure out what I'm going to do, and I move on.
Boy, that's smart. I mean, you don't make it drag at you. But let's talk about how you ended up in Paris with Mia Fonsegrives.
It was extraordinary. I started my career at 12. I loved clothes. My mother and I lived in Chevy Chase, Maryland. It's very grand. And the clothes, we were very competitive, Mom and me. We used to go to Garfinkel's. And I got a sewing machine to be able to create the things that I wanted that nobody else could have in Chevy Chase. So I started sewing. And then I realized I could sell the little things I made, like a little wrap skirt. Yeah. I could sell it to my very rich girlfriends whose fathers ran the government. So I made my first sale for $25 on a wrap skirt in burlap in turquoise with two buttons and a little flower there, and I was gone.
Yeah.
It was my money.
Which is something your father gave you great advice, which please tell our friends in the audience.
Daddy. Yeah. My father was a bachelor. My mom and dad divorced, and my father was very concerned. He was very guiding. Mom married one of the men in the IRS, and Daddy was a builder. And he was always a guide in my life. And when I went to school in New York, he took me out in Greenwich Village to a restaurant, and he said, I had very important things to tell you. Do you know how much money you spent last year? And I went, no, Daddy, including the trip to Europe. And he went, $25,000. That's a lot of money. And I want you to make your own money now, Vicki, because I'm not giving you any more. And I went, oh, you're kidding, Daddy.
Yeah.
It's not possible. Everybody gets Daddy to pay for them until the husband takes over.
Yeah.
And he said, no, Vicki, I had no sons. You're all I have. I want you to make your own money. If you have sex with your husband and ask for a pair of shoes, he's going to confuse you with a prostitute. So make your own money and pay for your own shoes. And so I have a chapter in my book, and I have a T-shirt, and it says no sex for shoes.
Yeah. Now you go to you went to
school. I went to Parsons. First I went to Pratt in Brooklyn, and I was in Brooklyn, and it was too far from the action. We were having a sexual revolution in Manhattan, and I was stuck in Brooklyn.
No way.
It was 1961, and all of these gorgeous men converted in Greenwich Village, in between Bleecker and McDougal. They were all coming with guitars and long hair and these tight jeans and leather jackets. And they were calling themselves, you know, bohemians, hippies. They were smoking pot, and they were singing, and they formed bands. Mm-hmm. And we were stuck in Brooklyn. So I had to get out of Brooklyn and go there, and I became Peaches Latour.
Yes. And Peaches Latour had a boyfriend named Steve.
Steve.
Which is interesting, because he plays back in your life quite a bit.
Yes. It was extraordinary. Yesterday, I was in San Diego, and I had a book signing, and I got to meet Steve's wife and his daughter. We were friends until his marriage, and he finally married after having the Arquette family. You have that chapter where I have outed Steve as the father of Rosanna Arquette.
Yeah.
But the wife he married, when my divorce from Ron came through, he said, that's it, Vicki, we're not having contact anymore. Yeah. But we were friends with each other for 25 years.
There are some sketches here. And I guess this is after you went to Paris.
No.
Oh, no.
No, those are sketches when I was a student in Parsons.
Well,
in school.
Many of them, of course,
miniskirts.
Ended up being the Vicki Teal look.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mia and I were unusual at the school. The school had students that were following the teacher's advice. And this is one of the things I do. I teach at FIT. I lecture the students.
Yeah.
And I say to them, if the teacher finds you to be the number one student, if you're getting the straight A's, if you're adored by the fashion critics, you're a terrible designer.
Yeah.
The rebel is the designer. The creator and the artist is the one that's the F student. So me and I were both bad students.
But you do go off to Paris.
Well, we started making these very, very short skirts.
Yeah.
And as I was in love with my folk singer, Steve, I had to turn him on, and his wife, the mother of Rosanna Arquette, was very beautiful. And I have a talk about how she was in my book, how she was, her portrait was over his bed. They had divorced, but he still adored her. And I had to be hotter than her. And that's how I made the mini skirt. Mia's mother was the most beautiful model in the world.
Lisa Fonsegreaves.
The most beautiful model in the world. Her dad was Fernand Fonsegreaves, and her stepdad was Irving Penn. The most famous photographer, the most beautiful mom. Yeah. She had the most beautiful legs, and she didn't know what to do, so she decided to show them. Yeah. So she created the first mini wrap skirt. It was Mia, actually, and not me, that made the skirt that wrapped around and like this that was way above the knee. And she'd come into Parsons with a T-shirt, an orange, and a purple piece of fabric raped around and a string going around these gorgeous hips. And she was 6 feet tall with heels on. And the teachers would go, oh, my God, go to Las Vegas.
Yeah. You get to France, and you do meet a man named Ron Barkley?
Berkeley. Yes, Ron Berkeley.
And he is the makeup man for Richard Burton and other famous stars, and almost like a Jean Chicove and some of the other people became the character for Shampoo. But through him, you meet Elizabeth Taylor. And I guess you did become very good friends.
Yes, she became my partner.
Yeah.
It was amazing. I have a drawing that I was showing the women in San Diego of when I was 14, I made a portrait of Elizabeth as my favorite actress. I was in art class and I drew it and I kept it all my life framed. And at 20 years old, I'm making a Woody Allen movie. It was Woody's first movie. Yeah. And I'm doing What's New Pussycat and the costumes and I'm introducing the mini skirt in movies. And in the studio of Billancourt in Paris is the movie Sandpiper. Now, Elizabeth had made the movie Sandpiper in Paris because it was taking place in Big Sur, but she had to eat French. So because she had to eat French, she said, I have to eat French. Yeah. So we had to make the whole movie, she had to make the whole movie in Paris.
Yeah.
And they had the backdrops from Big Sur put behind her so she could eat French.
But my guest was having her 21st birthday. And there were two men, Woody Allen and somebody else.
Clive Donner,
who,
the director.
An Englishman.
Yeah.
And they all had their eyes on Vicki Teal, which one only has to look at this picture to understand why they did. But the game was, on her 21st birthday, one of them would be her lover. I guess that's all one can
Whoever
say.
Whoever gave me the best 21st birthday present got to sleep with me.
Yes. So,
it's the 60s.
Unfortunately, during the day, she bumped into a man named Ron Berkeley, and before you knew it, that's all they wrote. I think I did that pretty genteelly.
Yeah.
Yes.
That was fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, not for Woody. Woody was upset. As a matter of fact, at the Cannes Film Festival, Woody was talking about Midnight in Paris. He shot this movie, and then he had the backdrop of the movie poster where the street where my shop is, because we've stayed friends, and it's just always kind of a little tick to me, you know. And so Woody was completely upset about that, but we have a chapter in there which is called Woody Gets Even in the book. And he got even.
Right.
We stayed friends, and I married Ron, and then I had a baby. And my baby was 9 months pregnant, and I went out with Woody, because we stayed friends, to a nightclub in Paris, and Ron was shooting in South Africa. He was making a movie.
Yeah.
And Woody took me out, and we went downstairs, and the paparazzi were photographing us, and Woody goes like this to hide my big belly.
Yeah.
And his hand is on me like this, and we're both looking like that, and it's in all the magazines in America, Vicky Teal has Woody Allen's baby.
Yeah.
So my husband comes back from Africa, and the baby is born. He says, if that baby, and I'm in the delivery room, comes out with red hair, you're divorced. And the baby comes out with red hair. And Woody was so happy.
How long were you married to Ron?
I was with him 21 years.
Yeah. So. There's a point where you know he is cheating.
A rabbit.
Shall we say there are three types of rabbits?
There's three types of men, and I have the rabbit test.
Yes.
The rabbit test, there's a rabbit, a non-rabbit, and a snake rabbit. And my first husband was a rabbit. My second husband is a non-rabbit.
Yes.
The rabbit test is you take a man that you're in love with, that you consider for husband material, to the restaurant where all the most beautiful women walk in, and you put him facing the door. And if you watch him, is his reaction as the beautiful girls walk by, a rabbit will do this. And he'll look and he'll focus to see her derriere.
Yeah.
A sort of a rabbit will go like this, but he's okay, you can marry him. It goes like that. But a rabbit, the whole thing goes around, the head swings around the second she walks by while you're talking to him, while you're eating dinner, and you can't marry a rabbit. Ron, unfortunately, I was young, was a rabbit.
Yes.
Yeah.
And Ron he's been around as far as Hollywood goes. He was there.
Ron was the makeup man with Elizabeth for her early movies. They did like, I think, 10 movies altogether.
Yeah.
And he was with her. He's a year older. They started at MGM. His daddy was at MGM. She was a child star, and he did Raintree County. He did all of her early movies.
Yeah.
He did Elvis's movies. He did Debbie Reynolds' movies. And he ended up with Richard Burton. He fell in love with Richard Burton, and the two of them just like that.
Yeah. And it was fortunate because after a while there was a foursome because of you with Elizabeth and the entourage.
I mean, we were 12.
Yeah.
And then there was the luggage.
Yeah.
Unbelievable luggage. Yeah.
Demands that were made on you then?
Not really. I loved Elizabeth, and they called me their daughter. They would call me. Richard would write me letters. Richard loved to wake up first thing in the morning and write.
Yeah.
And he would just get up, go to his little English green typewriter. I think it was one of the earliest typewriters ever. He had it from Oxford. He put it down, and he'd get up at 5 o'clock in the morning and just write away.
Yeah.
Ron would get a letter, and we'd save them. I'd get letters, and we'd save them. And so it was just an amazing family feeling.
But you also designed clothes for Richard's third and fourth wife. Yeah.
Elizabeth is such a generous heart. That when I called her and said, is it okay, Susie.
Oh.
Susie, a tall blonde that he met on a ski lift. Susie.
But he had had another wife before Elizabeth. That's
the
why
mom
I say
of Kate's
third.
Mom, yeah.
Yeah.
Sybil, yeah. Susie, a blonde from the ski lift he met, and she was a very nice lady. And she wanted to wear Elizabeth's red leather jumpsuit. So I asked if it was okay. And Elizabeth, with a big heart, said, oh, it's okay, dear. I love my jumpsuit. Yeah. And I have several of them. Let her have them. It's Richard loves red. It's for whales.
Yeah.
So then the third wife, Sally, wanted to wear the red leather jumpsuit. And it was perfectly okay. I mean, just the most generous heart.
But I couldn't get over the facts of her not allowing Elizabeth to come to Richard's funeral.
Have you ever?
And you really portray or almost paint a picture of what went on in that town in Switzerland and with Richard's relatives from Wales.